we are almost finished, and so here we I have three element. For the element number one, and you see for the element number one there is 1 1 1 2 1 3 1 4, again 2 1 2 2 2 3 2 4, again 3 1 3 2 3 3 3 4 4 1 4 2 4 3 4 4. So we are just producing K11, that means 1 2 1 3 1 4, that means this is 4 by 4. It depends on the Lagrange basis function number. It is 2, then the matrix will be 3 by 3. It is 1, that means matrix will be 2 by 2. And again, this is element 1 and this is for element 2 and this is for element 3. So you see at the last of that, that means 4 by 4 matrix, I add K44 and K11. So here you see for the element number 1, K44, and element number 2, K11, is the same point, right? So that's why we add it. And again for this one, element number 2, K44, for the element number 3, K11 are the same, right? So we are adding this one, element number 1, and there, element 2, 3, this one. And our matrix is 10 by 10. So let's talk about some MATLAB code. So we are calling this global local to global coordinate, and then we say this local point, we say this one is n+1, as we discussed the previous video number 4. So here, and we call the elemental stiffness matrix load vector, and the xx point. So xx point produced from here, from there, and k we produce a 0-0 matrix. This is stiffness, global stiffness matrix, and n. So nn, it comes from the global coordinate, and this is the local. Load global stiffness matrix we produce, as this is a vector, and this is for our graph drawing. So this is later, and okay, so here we say that K global equals to K global, that means we are calling the this one elemental stiffness matrix in here and adding it 1 by 1. You see here the stiffness is 1 2 3 4, so you have to add this element 1 by 1 and produce a matrix. So we are producing a matrix. You see the ij, so ij global, it's come from here. So n e e, so we say the local point is equals to I, and I equals I, there is a loops, and for j there is also a loops, I j loops, and for the load, total load, it depends on the only I. So here we call the load vector and produce this one, and the xx, and here also k, we produce the global stiffness matrix K, and then we close the loops. So okay, so now we are calling the boundary condition. So how can you define the boundary condition? For we take in here K total, this is n by n, that means 10 by 10 matrix. So for the for this one, this whole rows, that means rows number 1, we make it 0. We make it 0 here. We say that total row number 1, all the column is 0, and provide 1 1 at 1 here. This one I make 1. This is our the boundary condition system. So all are 0, there is only 1. So here, and the for the load matrix, so the load in here, load vector, this one. So we make it first 0 and then insert our initial temperature is 300 Kelvin. So we produce this one as 300 Kelvin and divide it here. So at the initial end, we have to divide it for the temperature K elemental divided by load vector. K elemental divided by load vector. And here at the main function, we have to give these parameters n, e, x max, x mean. So we give in here x max 1 as this is my here x max is 1, x mean is 0, number of element is 3, and quadrature n equals to degree of order is 3. Degree of order is 3. And we give the title x max and float x total this one. So let's run about our program. So here is our value, as initial value is 300 and it is increases fx equal to x 31. So here at the xx 1 you find there and this value. And if you say that okay, I want to change something, element number is I say 100 and this is I say for example let's say 10th order and see what is produced. So it takes time because it is 10th order and you see already it produced the answer for the 100 elements. Okay. Wow. So you see our initial temperature is 300, okay, and the last one is 301. So for the element when there was element is 3, you see the last element last one is 301 and the initial is 300. That okay, so okay, I can run it. Just want to see the figure, and this is the figure. So you see the finely merge it. So in here you can define 20, 30, no problem, any order, any element, any x max, any x min. And you have to be careful if you give x max as 1, you have to change this k value in here because it is defined only for 1. That's it. So if you need the code, please give a comment in the comment box mentioning your email address and subscribe my channel. I will talk later about how to solve using spectral analysis method, 2D finite element and 3D finite element later. Thanks for watching my video.